Welcome to another NUCIDA video. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time. Hi, in this NUCIDA video, I'm going to introduce TestRail, a powerful test management tool used by testers and developers all over the world to organize and manage their testing efforts more efficiently. By choosing TestRail, you unlock a key ingredient that will help you prepare your recipe for success. In this tutorial series, you'll learn the basics of TestRail, from documenting your test cases, plans, and runs to capturing real-time results and generating meaningful reports. If your team is new to TestRail, we highly recommend forwarding this training video to all your team members. Please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell to never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. All right, let's get started. Because TestRail is a web application, you can access it with all modern web browsers, such as Google Chrome, Firefox, Safari, Microsoft Edge, and more. You can install TestRail on your server or choose our cloud-based SaaS solution. Hosted on our fast and secure servers, the cloud edition of TestRail includes full software maintenance and automatic updates. Okay, now let's log in. The first thing we see when we log into TestRail is the dashboard page, which provides an overview of your project's to-dos and recent project activities. You can find the to-dos here at the right sidebar. Teams often ask us how they can organize their projects in TestRail. Our suggestion is to always create different projects for each actual product or project you work on. If you are working on multiple product versions, you should add those under the same project. Now let's open a project and see how it looks. Okay, now you can see some additional navigational elements at the top of the screen. These are overview, to-do, milestones, test runs and results, as well as test cases and reports. Currently, we are on the overview page, where you can get a lot of information about your project immediately. Here at the top, you can see the project progress chart. You can also see the upcoming milestones and the latest test runs. Before we move on to another page, it is important to mention that you can also mark a project as completed. To do this, click Edit and add a check mark on the Project is Completed field. This will move the project into a separate section on the dashboard. That makes it so much easier to see all active projects briefly and not confuse them with the ones that are already completed. Alright, now that you have an overview on how to get started, you can begin organizing your projects in TestRail to learn about the different project types, test suites and cases, how to run tests, and take advantage of our mini customization options. In this video, you will learn all about TestRail's different project types. As discussed in the other videos, projects are an important aspect of TestRail. Whenever you add a new project in TestRail, you can always choose between three different project types: a single repository for all cases, a single repository with baseline support, and multiple test suites. The type of project you use will define how you organize and manage your test cases within that project. For most teams, a single test repository for all cases is recommended due to its simplicity. With this project type, you will have a single area in which all your cases for that project are stored, and you can further divide them into sections and subsections. Using a single repository keeps things simple and allows for full end-to-end testing within a single run, while also maintaining flexibility around concurrent testing, with versioning using milestones and test plans. You can also use a single repository with the additional option of creating baselines. These baselines can be used to manage multiple versions of your test cases at the same time. This is ideal if you need additional version controls to test multiple product releases in parallel. With this type, you create a master set of test cases. Then you can split them into different baselines, which allows you to make changes to the test cases in the baselines without affecting the master test cases. In earlier versions of TestRail, the multiple suites project type was the only project type available. This option is still available, but should be reserved for teams that require much stricter divisions between different testing areas in their system. Multiple suites gives you another logical division point within a project for splitting your tests into separate project branches, features, or testing areas. This approach works well for many teams, but does have limitations when creating runs that would be larger in scope. Beyond the cases included in a single suite, users can always change the project type when editing an existing project or adding a new one. In this video series, we will primarily demonstrate the basics of TestRail with the default single repository type. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our ISTQB, ITK, X-Ray, and TestRail certified QA experts will reply in time or even produce a separate video about your topic. Please also check out our other over 200 videos about software quality. Happy testing. See you next time.